when you are using a software library, you are supposed to know what are the methods or classes or objects that you are going to call from the library. But when you are using a framework, the framework will call the application specific code, that is the code developed by you will be called from the framework, and that action inversion is called inversion of control. And because of this, we can be able to achieve the decoupling between the classes. You don't need to worry about the, again I said earlier, you don't need to worry about the what other developers do, and you can just concentrate on your own code. You can just concentrate on the unique requirements of the applications instead of the application structure. And one of the, there is another point called the dependency injection. Both inversion of control and dependency injection are the same. Why we differ the name is, inversion of control is the common term which is actually every application code would like to have that name. But dependency injection is something different that will give you the instance variables at the time when you need it. That we will explain later. We will just first look into the IOC, that is inversion of control, with an example. As you can see, the first example on the left side of your screen, that is a class is there, class A, and there is another, there is a variable B of type B, that is class B. And as you can see, as you want to use the class B in your code, that is in your class A, suppose class A is developed by you and you want to use class B, what you are doing over here is, in the constructor of class A, you are again constructing class B, which is, you need to, whatever the changes happened in class B needs to be affected over here, which means there's a tight coupling between class A and class B. Whereas in another case, when you are using an IOC, you are having a setter over here, the same class A, and there's a setter function over there. The what the framework IOC will do is, it will create the constructor of class B and will give it to the setter function of class A, which means there's a decoupling. The class A doesn't need to know about what's happening in class B or how it's constructed or what it's how it's instantiated. It will just accept the class B and it will act according to that. And the above example is explained over here. I think it's not clear, but I'll tell you. The first case without IOC on the left side, there are two classes, object A and object B. While you require object B, the object A needs to construct that and it has to give it. But whereas in the right hand side, with IOC, the object A doesn't need to worry about the construction of object B, whereas IOC framework will construct it and will give it to the object A. So, and the next one would be dependency injection. Like I said earlier, both are same, inversion of control and dependency injection. Actually, this term dependency injection was actually derived by Mr. Martin Fowle. And dependency injection means giving an object its instant variables, which means whenever the object needs the another object's instance, you can inject it into your class. So again, by this we are going to achieve decoupling. Loosely coupled classes can be constructed. And here a simple example of usual service locator pattern, simple comparison between a usual service locator pattern and a dependency injection pattern. As you can see on the left side, in usual service locator pattern, the client class will just give an instruction to the service locator, and the duty of service locator over here is, it will not construct any services instances, it will just root out the services, it will just root out the instructions from the client class and it will just return back the results to the client class. The client clerks needs to worry about the construction of services and all those things. Whereas in a DA pattern, there will be a builder, context builder, which means a central IOC container will be there, and which will take care of, it will create the instances of service classes. As you can see in the right side, it creates the instances of service classes, and by the same time it injects whenever the client class is needed, it injects. So that's a decoupling, object decoupling is there. You can further decouple the services in, into iService 1, that is by using an interface you can further abstract the classes. So that's what I explained with dependency injection. There are three types of dependency injection as far as ActionScript frequency is concerned. One is constructor injection, and the next one is setter injection. Third one is property injection. We'll see what are they. As you can see here, constructor injection. That's a class called myObject, and there is a variable called dependence on, that is of type I dependency, that is an interface. The constructor of my object accepts one parameter, that is of type I dependency, which means the dependency class implements this I dependency interface, and this can be mapped to your local class using this dot depends on equal to that parameter which comes in, which means that this class doesn't need to, this is the same as the above example, this class doesn't need to worry about what I dependency means. It's injecting the I dependency class into the my object class whenever it's needed. In this case, it's needed while it's constructing. So it's instructing at that point. As you can see the usage, how it's been used. That's an object creation, I mean construction about my object class. While constructing itself, we are giving a dependency class as a parameter to the constructor. So this can be achieved through constructor injection. And the next one is through setter injection. Again, the same class, my object, there is another same variable dependency on. Here, how we can see how this I dependency class has been injected to the my object class. That's a setter function. As usual, it's quite simple. This is happening in every bit of this, even simple